गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज वीर सिंह राजपूत फ्रॉम सरस्वती क्लासेस। इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर आई हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट एडवांटेज एंड लिमिटेशंस ऑफ अकाउंटिंग, राइट। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द यूजर्स ऑफ अकाउंटिंग, विच आर द पर्सन हु यूज द अकाउंटिंग्स द मोस्ट एंड व्हाट इज देयर नीड्स, why they have a requirement to know the accounting, to get the information regarding the information of any company's accounting, why they need all these data. So it is in somehow, as we know that company's progress and company's failures is to be seen by every person, every single person who is in that field or who is related with that field. But in that context, there are certain users who desperately requires the data, accounting data of companies, right? And according to government regulations, every company has to disclose their profit and loss, balance sheets and all data which are related with the company to the public. Company will have to send the details, every kind of details regarding company's progress or failure during the year, what had happened to its shareholders. But nowadays, government has ordered all the companies to put their all the data on computers, so that any persons who are in demand of any information regarding the accounting status of any company, they can go to the cyber cafe and get whatever the data they are requiring, right? So today we are going to study about the users of accounting and their needs, why they need all this data, right? So today we are going to start. It is the first one is management. Now why management is needing their accounting data? Management is needing the accounting data desperately because what kind of rules and regulations set up by the management, whether those rules and regulations are working properly or not, whether whatever the predetermined plans which are planned by the management, whether the plans are working or not, whether the estimates, whatever the estimates are to be estimated by the management, they are going to be fulfilled or not. This all accounting data is to be gettable only when we prepare accounting. If we don't prepare accounting, this data will not be gettable. That's why this is in very much need of for the management to know their accounting. Second one thing is shareholders. Now, according to the some authors, or it is a basic fact that shareholders are the real owners of the companies. Company के जो सच्चे मालिक होते हैं वो shareholders ही होते हैं. The reason is because all the risk they bears. जितना भी risk होता है market का, सिर्फ shareholders. And which kind of shareholders? Equity shareholders. They are known as risky shareholders. Right? So shareholders must know why there is need of understanding or knowing the accounting information, their needs to shareholders. Shareholders are in need because after getting the data of company's progress or accounting, profit or loss, shareholders are able for demanding bonus. If they found that company is not getting enough profit, they will not in condition to put their demands, right? And another one thing, If shareholders understand the company is progressing, he will definitely go to other two persons, and other two persons will to the next two person, and they will inform other persons that they will advertise the benefit. They will advertise the company's policy only when the company is profiting. Only when the company is growing. They will desperately go to the persons and speak them, my company is doing very good. When I purchased a share, it was of 10 rupees, now it is 110 rupees. Right? But when it is happen? It will be happen only when you are growing, your business is growing. Another topic that we are going to discuss, potential shareholders. Potential shareholders means those shareholders who desperately want to purchase the shares from the company. Creditors. Now creditors are those persons who have given raw material on credit to the company in a big amount, in a big lot. Now this is very important for them too, because if they know the financial condition of the company, then after watching the condition of the company, they will be able to understand whether we should give raw material to the company on credit or not. If company is doing bad, good, then they don't have any issue regarding giving raw material on credit. But when company is in the loss condition, then what? Is it possible for them to give raw material? No. They will not give. That's why they are in requirement about the accounting condition of the companies. Next point is employees. Now, employees are the workers with the help of those companies getting profit. And with the help of them, companies are stable in the market. Right? Without employees, no one can assume. If I have power, if I have money, if I have machinery, if I have management, but if there is no worker, then it is not possible to set up ourselves as a company in the market. For that we need an employee, a worker. तो उनके लिए क्यों जरूरी है ये? उनके लिए ये जरूरी है that companies के employee को क्या चाहिए होता है? Companies employees demands only certain things. First one, good salary. Second one, status. Third one, family security, medical expenses like that. Fourth one, after certain period of time, they want increment in their salaries. Right? So there are certain things which workers are desperately needed. तो वर्कर्स यही देखते हैं. वर्कर्स क्यों देखना चाहते हैं? एम्प्लॉयज क्यों देखना चाहते हैं कंपनी की फाइनेंशियल कंडीशन को? दे वांट्स टू सी नो द फाइनेंशियल कंडीशन ऑफ द कंपनी बिकॉज़, क्योंकि वो इसलिए जानना चाहते हैं क्योंकि अगर कंपनी की फाइनेंशियल कंडीशन अच्छी होगी तो कंपनी की ग्रोथ के लिए ये अंदर कुछ और डिमांड्स रख सकते हैं, या फिर अपनी कोई व्यक्तिगत जो मांगें होती हैं, डिमांड्स होती है, उनको पूरा करने के लिए वो लोग डिमांड्स रख सकते हैं. बट दिस इज ओनली हैपन व्हेन कंपनी आर इज इन गुड पोजीशन. राइट? दैट इज द रीजन व्हाई द एम्प्लॉयज नीड्स द अकाउंटिंग इंफॉर्मेशन ऑफ द कंपनी. आफ्टर दैट, tax authority. As we know that government charges tax for those persons, from those persons who are capable enough to earn money. If a business is getting loss, government is not going to charge any kind of tax from them. But the main thing is what? When company is getting good profit, then and then only the tax authorities are able to calculate the required tax on company. Right? So according to tax authority, there are certain limitations given, there are certain incomes are tax criteria was is fixed that at what level we should pay tax to the government. If we are crossing certain limit, that your tax rate will be increased. So everything is depend upon income. Now when I can show, or when a tax department can charge tax on us, they can charge tax on us when they have the exact data of our income and expenditure of the company. When they know that company is in sufficient condition, or when company is earning the profit which is described or more than limitations, then government take charge tax on that. Next point is customers. Now customers ki kya zarurat hai? Customer ki zarurat hai ye kyunki customers ye dekhte hain that company is doing good, means कंपनी के जो प्रोडक्ट हैं वो मार्केट में अच्छे बिक रहे हैं, दे आर मोर रिलायबल, इवन कस्टमर्स आर इन गुड ट्रस्ट और हैविंग सम काइंड ऑफ फेथ रिगार्डिंग द प्रोडक्ट इफ अवर कंपनी इज इन गुड कंडीशंस, राइट. रिलायंस के शेयर्स का देखो, मैं कभी अनिल अंबानी से नहीं मिला, मुकेश अंबानी से नहीं मिला, धीरू भाई अंबानी से नहीं मिला, but I have a good faith in Reliance. Why? Because I have studied the accounting of Reliance Industries. They are strong enough कि अगर एक बार loss भी होगा तो अपने shareholders को डूबने नहीं देंगे, वो उनको double bonus के साथ वापस अपना trust भी gain कर लेंगे और उनको अच्छा benefit भी दे देंगे. ऐसा कैसे possible है? तो ऐसा तब possible है जब management खुद का नुकसान सहन करके अपने shareholders को क्या करता है, वो ऊपर उठाने की कोशिश करता है. सो सिमिलरली देयर आर अदर सर्टेन कंपनीज टू, विप्रो कैन बी सेड इन गुड, टाटा स्टील कैन बी सेड इन गुड टच लाइक रिलायंस, राइट. दे आर सम रेप्यूटेड कंपनीज विच कैन यू नो मेंटेन देयर वर्कर्स, मेंटेन देयर शेयर होल्डर्स आफ्टर गिविंग देम अ गुड एंड यू नो हैंडसम अमाउंट रिगार्डिंग बोनस, एज बोनस. रेगुलेटरी बॉडीज में क्या होता है, देखो अगर कंपनी है तो कंपनी में या तो इंडिविजुअल होगी या फिर गवर्नमेंट की अंडरटेकिंग होगा, लेकिन जब शेयर्स से रिलेटेड कोई भी बात आ जाती है तो वहां पर सेबी, सिक्योरिटी एक्सचेंज बोर्ड ऑफ इंडिया, उसकी कुछ गाइडलाइंस हैं, वो शेयर मार्केट के ऊपर पूरी वॉच रखती है whether the shareholders are protected or not. If there is any kind of misguiding not to be done with the shareholders, shareholder का किस तरह का कोई loss तो नहीं हो रहा है, उसको देखने के लिए SEBI की स्थापना की गई है, and which is in the watch of regarding the shareholders. Next point, professional bodies. Professional bodies like चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट्स, हम जो अकाउंटेंट्स हैं, हम अकाउंट्स कैसे लिखते हैं, हम जो अकाउंट्स हैं कैसे पढ़ाते हैं, समझो. अकाउंट्स आर टू बी चेंज्ड आफ्टर सर्टेन पीरियड ऑफ टाइम, क्योंकि अभी जो हम अकाउंटिंग मेथड यूज कर रहे हैं, आफ्टर सर्टेन पीरियड ऑफ टाइम योर अकाउंटिंग मेथड विल बी चेंज्ड. और चेंज कौन करेगा? तो अकॉर्डिंग टू इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट्स, वो हर साल कोई ना कोई नई मेथड डेवलप करते रहते हैं, और उनकी डेवलप की मेथड्स के हिसाब से ही हम लोग क्या करते हैं, जो नए शेड्यूल्स आते हैं उस हिसाब से हम बच्चों को आगे क्या करते हैं, टीच करते हैं, राइट. दीज आर द थिंग्स वी और दीज आर दीज आर द यूजर्स विच यूज अकाउंटिंग इन अ बिग मैनर, एंड वी हैव डिस्कस्ड व्हाट आर देयर नीड्स एंड व्हाई दे नीड टू नो द अकाउंटिंग सिस्टम ऑफ द कंपनी, राइट. For today it is all over. We'll come with the next lecture. Till then, goodbye.